Welcome everyone. In today's session, we will see in detail the importance of pictures and their use in print media. As you all know, photography is an integral part of print media. It is a photograph that makes a story authentic and visually appealing. Sometimes, a picture is enough to tell a story, and there are instances when editors decide to kill a story and give maximum display to an excellent photograph. That is why it is said that a good picture is worth 1,000 words. Here I will show you an example for you. You can see this photograph. They have given maximum space for this photograph and it stands alone. So such photographs are called standalone pictures. Also, you can take a look at some more standalone pictures. You can also notice a brief photo caption along with these pictures. Every newspaper has photographers who work from designated places. Whenever there is a major incident like an accident or natural calamity, it is a photographer who reaches the spot first. During such times, it is the photographer who gives the story lead to the reporter. Photojournalists need a passion for current affairs, creative flair, and technical ability to be successful in the competitive field of press photography. Press photographers take photographs to record news, current events, and lifestyle stories. They aim to capture the best images to document an event, tell a story, or convey a message and support the printed word. When you see a photo in the newspaper, you look for what is written under it. This description under a photo is called the catchword or caption. When photographers file photos, it is a job of the copy editor to write the appropriate caption. A good caption can improve the impact of the picture. Placing photograph in a page involves picture editing. Picture editing involves placing the picture in the correct position in the page. It is part of the page layout. Usually in the front page, only very important news pictures will find a place. Pictures can also be classified into various categories like news pictures, human interest pictures, sports pictures, etc. It is the editor who finally decides on the number of pictures to be carried in each page. Chances are that newspaper photographs have these qualities or factors that play into their making and choosing. The dominant element will be in or near the center of the frame. You can probably draw an oval in the center portion of most of the photographs, and what is outside the oval will not be important. Something active will be happening, and the photograph will only be about that active verb layer, people doing things. What is behind the action layer of the photograph will often be irrelevant to the composition and won't add to understanding or compositional dynamic. A given photograph will be made and chosen more because of the photograph's caption than the strength of the image. Light and color are often sacrificed because the photo had to be made at a time when neither quality was optimal. This happens while covering accidents or natural calamities. Chances are that if what was photographed is not interesting, the photograph will not be interesting. As we have learned that caption is important for a news photograph, let us check how a caption is given. Writing a caption and cut line for a photograph is itself an art. It is a creative work. Here are some tips for writing a good caption. Focus on the main idea of photo taken. Use short sentence to sum up all information you want to share. Writing a caption is important because it provides additional information to the photograph. This brings to the fore what one cannot see by merely staring at a picture. Without a caption, readers will be faced with the challenge of many unanswered questions about a photograph, such as who is in the picture, what is it about, where was it taken, when was it taken, why did this action occur, and how did it occur. No matter how good a photographer is, without a good caption, it will not communicate effectively. It is important to check grammar and spelling mistakes. When it comes to a page, it is the pictures and headlines that strike the eyes of readers. So, adding a visual element plays a key role in attracting reader attention to a story. Editors choose front page picture carefully to attract readers. The layout of the front page, headline, and photographs used are important factors that determine the level of attention given to the newspaper. News pictures are selected for their action and content rather than any aesthetic consideration. Photographs in newspapers inform, educate, and enlighten readers about current issues and also reflect on the past as well. They enhance the credibility of the stories. As they depict reality, they also furnish evidence to show the authenticity of a news story or give proof of an event that occurred. Its aesthetic values enable a photograph to serve as a tool to attract readers' attention and break the monotony of news content. Thus, photographs enhance and beautify the pages of a newspaper. A photograph in newspaper speaks more than 1,000 words. No formal education is required to understand a picture. Photographs are therefore able to break through literacy barrier to effectively communicate a message. It is a universal language. Now, we are going to learn the categories of newspaper photograph. First one being the sport news. These are pictures that communicate information. These are pictures that communicate information about news break. Such events have to be reported immediately to prevent the news from going stale. Examples of sport pictures are crime, riot, protest, accident, fire disaster, etc. The photojournalist covering such event has no control over the events. Thus, he or she must report it as it unfolds, because any opportunity to capture the scene once lost cannot be regained. Second category is general news. Unlike sport news, general news pictures are recorded events that can be delayed and yet not go stale. Photographs on general news include politics, press or social events. They must portray something new or exhibit other news values such as prominence, magnitude, oddity, etc. Next is a feature photograph. Features provide visual break from routine news pictures. A news picture accrues values when its subject is famous, the event is of large magnitude, or the outcome is tragic. However, a feature picture by contrast records the commonplace, the everyday, in a new or unusual way. They tell an old story in a new way or from a new point of view. Next category is portraits. They are used to tell a person's story. Photojournalists shoot both posed and candid portraits to achieve this. Even when they arrange elements for portrait, photojournalists look for honest, candid moments. Portraits reveal something about a person's personality. Thus, photojournalists strive to project this in their portrait pictures. Next comes sports photograph. Sports photographers are like athletes. They strive to capture in a unique way the fast-paced action and drama of competition. a good sports photograph and a well-written news story have similar characteristics. They are both timely and both have a higher reader interest. A sports picture summarizes the game in one photograph in a timely manner. The sports photographer captures interesting, unusual, emotional, and unexpected action on and off the sport field. Next category is the photo story. This refers to editorial photographs that tell narrative stories. For many photojournalists, telling stories with pictures is the ultimate professional experience. The story must be planned and well organized to present a complete detailed account of an interesting and significant subject, event and personality aspect of contemporary life in a narrative form. Sometimes stories can be built in a matter of minutes, other times it takes months or years. The Hindu on Sundays carries such photo stories. Here you can see how a photo story is made. The role of a photojournalist is to report news and tell stories through these various means. Whichever form of photography he or she chooses, it is important for the photojournalist to capture issues of interest. For example, an issue of overcrowded classroom or an environmental degradation such as flooding calls for such issues to be translated into pictures or communicated visually through photographs. Therefore, a photojournalist is a journalist first and photographer second. Photographs can also be used for agenda setting. This refers to the power of visual image to shape what the readers will talk about, thus influencing the public perception of societal issues. Photographs, unlike moving images, freeze an action. These pictures appeal to people's conscience and try to change people's opinion by challenging them to react to the message the image communicates. Photographs, when well selected, have a responsibility of shaping people's perception. It is a medium that plays a major role as a document and a witness to events. Photographs have an ability to bring about a reform or social change in the society. Therefore, it is important for photographs published on newspapers to create awareness about relevant issues to enable the government or those affected take appropriate action to effect change. The citizen journalist column run by the Times of India is a perfect example for this. It is a dedicated space in the city page to accommodate photographs sent by the general public. The photograph should highlight a public issue in that particular area. It can be about garbage menace, lack of street lights, gutters on the road, damaged water pipeline or parking issue. These photographs often draw the attention of authorities and they take action to rectify the issue. Here is a look at the citizen journalist column. The selection of good pictures has increasingly become a crucial factor when transmitting news to the recipients. Every day, thousands of events are happening and millions of pictures are taken. By choosing photographs for newspapers and magazines, photographic editorial departments want to attract the recipient's attention, evoke emotions, and get them to read their stories. Here are some factors that an editor keeps in mind while selecting a picture for publishing. They are news factors. The important news factors are damage, violence or aggression, controversy, celebrities, unexpectedness, and emotions. A strong representation of a photo news factor in most cases leads to intensified attention of subjects. That means the duration of picture viewing is longer, pictures are more often recalled and better evaluated, and the viewing of an image with a strong representation of the photo news factor leads to an increased interest in reading the respective article. The more explicit an event is visually illustrated, the higher is the probability that the reader engages in a photo and becomes activated to get further involved in the coverage. Of course, not all moments are captured, and there is an element of luck in the best news photography. Too often, the great photographs are associated with war and death. Remember the iconic photograph taken during Vietnam War by the then Associated Press photographer Nick Coote. Let us take a look at the photograph once again. This photograph changed the course of Vietnam War and fetched Nick Coote the Pulitzer Prize and the World Press Photo Award. The image shows the Narpam girl, a 9-year-old girl running naked along with other children on a road after being severely burnt on her back by a South Vietnamese Narpam attack. It is after this photograph that officials concerned realized the brutality of the war, and this served as one of the reasons to end the war. Nick Coote recently told in an interview to The Wire, "After taking a few images, my humanity said that I should take care of these children, especially the girl. I hurriedly put them in a van and drove to the nearest hospital, which was 40 minutes away. I knew the girl would die. Her body was badly burnt, but she survived and I had my picture." Next, we will go through the qualities required for a news photographer. The news photographer must know how the camera works, how the exposure meter works, how filters will exaggerate definition and produce cloud effects. There is no room for subtle shading and lighting in news photography. Light effects must be strong, features well outlined. The photographer must do his or her work as thoroughly as the reporter. He or she must have some idea what the picture is going to be. As the reporter is always on the lookout for new angles and developments of a story, the photographer will have one eye on the unusual picture. It is up to the photographer to do research. Like the reporter, photographer may sometimes check with reference books before going out on an assignment. If they are going to photograph someone who is not familiar to them, they may check with the picture library beforehand and look at previous pictures of the subject so that they will not miss the person. The news photographer does not simply point his or her camera at a scene and hope for the best. He or she composes a picture as an artist does. He or she will look for strong vertical and horizontal lines for a balanced picture. For this, they will try to get to the assignment as early as possible and examine the city. Photographer then picks a vantage point. The subject can't always pose for the photograph, particularly in photographing hard news. So, if the picture is of someone emerging from a doorway, the photographer will focus the camera in advance on some point on the step. The setting changes often. A policeman moves the photographer's back a split second before the door opens and the subject emerges. Or even worse, the policeman stands immediately in front of the camera. Then the photographer must move and fast. He or she learns to manipulate the controls of the camera. At present, there is often competition with television camera persons, who may have lights that can radically affect the press pictures. If the TV people switch on their lights as subject emerges, the press photographers must adjust their cameras to the changed lighting. The best press pictures are seldom set up, but are the result of a photographer snatching the precise moment or action. Having seen the various categories of news photographs and their impact on the society, let us go through some significant photographs that got published in the recent period. This is the photograph that woke up the world to the Syrian refugee crisis. 3-year-old Alan Kurdi lying face down on a sandy beach in Turkey shook our consciences. The Syrian boy's lifeless body had washed ashore after the rubber boat carrying him and his family to Greece capsized. Until the photo by Turkish photographer Nilufer Demir appeared in September 2015, people did not seem focused on the humanitarian crisis in Syria. But Alan's photo mobilized empathy and concern, soon bringing in record donations to charitable organizations around the world to aid the victims. Emotion is a critical factor in helping us understand an event, and it is a motivator that impels action. Alan's photo provided a window of opportunity for individuals to feel for the situation. Mumbai Mirror photo editor Sebastian D'Souza won the World Press Photo Award in 2009 for this picture of terrorist Ajmal Amir Kasab with an AK-47 at CST in Mumbai on the petrifying evening of 26/11 terror attack. The Times of India photographer Sriram Vernekar took this second picture of Kasab from the window of the Times of India building. The photographer was at the office of Times of India, which is located opposite CST, when he heard sounds of grenade explosions and firing from CST. He rushed out of the building with his camera towards the terminus and saw two terrorists walking out of CST and taking the footbridge next to the Times of India building. Vernekar then ran back inside the office and went to the second floor, from where he could see them clearly, and clicked a few photographs. The lensman wasn't, however, satisfied with the quality of the pictures and so decided to use the flash, which is when one of the terrorists turned and fired at the Times of India building when he saw the flash go off. Vernekar later testified in court during a hearing on the 26/11 case. When he was asked to identify the gunman whose picture he had clicked, he pointed at Kasab sitting in the dock. Vernekar and D'Souza were even praised by the Supreme Court for showing great courage in the face of adversity and presenting evidence that was extraordinary. This is the picture of an NDRF officer rescuing a sick child by sprinting across a bridge moments before it got submerged in gushing floodwaters in rain-ravaged Kerala. The Times of India photographer Gibson Shikera captured the picture and brought the daring act of the officer to public attention. He was later identified as Kanaya Kumar. The image has become the defining image of the weather disaster that struck Kerala and led to flooding in many parts. On rare occasions, newspapers break the norms and adopt an entirely different style. This is such an example when the Times of India Kerala edition, dated January 2, 2019, carried an array of photographs in the front page above the lead. The event, Women's World, was a first of its kind in the state and hence it was given prominence. Lakhs of women stood shoulder to shoulder across the national highways, creating a 620-kilometer long human wall from the northern end of Kasaragod to the southern tip in Thiruvananthapuram as part of a state-sponsored initiative to uphold gender equality. Let us conclude this session with these extraordinary images. Thank you.